As you can see, it's March 1st, and I'm gonna write a book in a month.
Hold up. Let's backtrack just a little bit so you can get some context. A couple months ago, I was talking with a friend who I discovered had a book published on Amazon, and I was surprised to hear how easy they said it was to do. They said all I truly needed was a book. So, that's kind of how this came about. I've always thought it'd be cool to be like a writer or something, but I literally have zero experience with it.
The only thing I really have is confidence.
I've never said anything more true than that. I mean, I think I'm pretty creative, and I write songs. This is a shameless plug to my band, End of Our Youth. And I'm a dungeon master for my friends. But other than that, not really a writer. But now, if I could get a book on Amazon, I could tell everyone I'm a published novelist.
It's really that simple.
It wasn't that simple. I looked up on theinternet.com what the minimum number of words were required for a book to be considered a novel, and it gave me a whopping 50,000 words. It looks like a lot, but I figured if I were to do it in a month, I could just divide that 50,000 over the 30 days, right? Which got me to...
roughly 1,700 words per day. I have to write 1,700 words?
Yeah. So the challenge ended up being this. I would have the book done March 31st and hit the minimum word requirement of 50,000 words. I wouldn't plan or prepare it all in advance, going in completely blind, and in the end, I wouldn't go back and edit. But after the month was done, I'd be a novelist. March came and I just needed to start writing. I got my headphones, my blue light glasses, played that good lo-fi hip-hop music beats to relax / study to, and I was off.
I'm nervous, so I'm excited, I don't know what to write, but here we go.
Fun fact, my Discover Weekly on Spotify has been nothing but lo-fi music for the past 6 weeks because of this. I hope you're happy. The first couple days had a pretty similar feeling to them.
This is crazy.
I was excited to be writing a book, but I was definitely pretty stressed out because I had no idea what I was doing. Which led me to try to do anything else but write.
It's not what it looks like, I'm just... it's breakfast. It's breakfast. It's breakfast.
I ended up writing for almost 3 hours the first couple days, sitting at this desk, staring at the screen, and just trying to will myself to write. Day 7 came around, and I had officially been writing for a whole week.
It's day 7, and honestly, I'm feeling pretty good. I actually feel like I have somewhat of an idea of where I want this to go. I don't know, I get here and I'll like sit down and then I'll just be able to type the words a lot quicker than the first couple days. And so maybe I'm just optimistic about the outlook of this all, but.
The only thing is I wasn't sure how long that would last. Days 8 through 11 were the same. I would sit down, stare at the screen, having no clue where to take the story, write a couple paragraphs, get myself into the rhythm of writing, and before I knew it, I had the words done for that day. I will say though, day 10, I dressed up fancy while I wrote, because 10 seemed like a good number to dress up for, and I thought it would give me like inspiration or something. Definitely didn't, but I felt fancy either way. March 12th started spring break for my university. Days 12 through 14, I was in Wisconsin visiting family. They have a huge family, really big house, loud and fun, but it definitely was difficult to write the words with a bunch of people constantly around me. Day 15, I came back to Chicago and then immediately was packing up again to go camping for the rest of spring break. Day 16, I wrote my book in some random family's house that has way too many of those word art things on the wall. Day 17 is when things got tough.
Honestly, I don't know what I was thinking writing the book the same month that spring break was happening in. I don't know, it's kind of tough. It's like I'm literally camping in the middle of the Smoky National Park. My laptop is not doing too hot. It's probably about to die soon. I guess I'll get it done somehow.
Before I started this challenge, it didn't even cross my mind that I would have to write over spring break and how hard that truly would be. I get horrible car sickness, so typing the chapter while riding in the car was out of the question, and I never really had time nor the mental capacity to type any other time. So when I got back March 20th, I was behind by 3 days. Which doesn't seem like that much. But considering each singular chapter was already taking over 2 hours to write, having to try and write 2 chapters a day to catch up was a bit more work.
I
Don't know why I thought I could get back from the trip and then just be able to write well. All I want to do is sleep and not do anything.
Days 21 through 24, I was not prepared for. The amount of rest I got from spring break was somewhat non-existent, and I never really caught up in sleep or the chapters. Days 25 and 26, I was at a Frisbee tournament, and so I wrote my chapters in one of the most youth room looking youth rooms I've ever been in. Day 27, I was in the final stretch, exhausted, overwhelmed, and still behind. Here's a video of me typing and literally falling asleep because of how exhausted I was, just for a little context. Each day ticked by and the stress continued to build up in me. Not only was I having to write this book, but it seemed like all of my classes decided that this last week of March would be the busiest week of work I've ever had. Multiple tests and quizzes for multiple classes, having multiple assignments for those same classes that had same tests and quizzes, and it was just a lot.
March 28th, and I don't know how to finish this book. I didn't think this would be the problem. I have 4 chapters left to wrap up this entire book that I've like set up so nicely, and then yet I have no idea what I'm gonna do with it. I mean, it's fine. All I feel like I'm doing is building the problem, and I'm not getting anywhere close to resolving it. This book is a disaster. It is a disaster. It is a disaster. I don't know what else to tell you. I don't know what else to tell you, dog.
Day 29, still behind. Day 30, stressed. Day 31.
I'm here, I guess. I am really, really struggling to finish this book. Like, really struggling. I've spent 30 days, 31 days, writing this book. And now I still have 2 more chapters to write. And I've been staring at my screen just wondering like how I'm even gonna finish this off. At the beginning of this journey, I said it's okay, it's not gonna be a good book, I just wanna write a book. And yet, through this whole time, in the back of my mind, I want it to be a good book. And so it's tough to be at this position where I need to wrap up this book in less than a day. And I'm worried that I'll write something and then it won't be as good of an ending as I want it to be. I'm worried that, like, I've taken so long to climb this mountain of a book that when I get to the top, the view isn't going to be as good as I thought it was going to be. It's frustrating, honestly. And yet, here I am, I'm forcing myself to try and write this book. And yet, I told myself I just need to write the book, and it doesn't have to be good, and yet here I am, standing, terrified at the idea of writing this and it not being good.
I have this weird problem where whenever I'm conflicted with things that I want to do and things I need to do, I never do either of them. Instead, I'll just sit on my phone or watch YouTube videos, distracting myself from being productive in any sense of the word. This book was seeming to take everything out of me. I was seriously considering just pushing the challenge back a couple days. The reality was nobody would know. There really isn't any way for you guys to prove that I did it except for my word. And that's what made this difficult. If I just wanted to make a good video, I didn't even need to write the book at all. But the challenge was more than just a good video. The day was coming to a close, and the end of this book didn't feel any closer than when I started. But I could just easily push it back a couple days. I could. Surprisingly, I mustered up just enough strength to get it done. I got it right here. The culmination of a month's work tied up in these 200 pages. It's kinda crazy, honestly. And I finished the book on time too, I'll show you the video for continuity's sake, just so you know I actually did it. This book is up on Amazon, by the way. You can buy it if you would like to, but please don't purchase this expecting to get, like, an amazing book. I mean, I was literally falling asleep half the time that I was writing it. You guys saw. Like, it's tough, but I am proud that I gave myself the challenge, and then I did it. This challenge was pretty difficult for me, because not only do I struggle with perfectionism, but I also struggle with self-discipline. And I guess, inadvertently, this challenge kind of addressed both of those aspects about myself. Because, let's be honest, if I were to try and actually write a good book, I would probably start, write for a little bit, hate it, think it's bad, delete it all, try again, and I'd be in this vicious cycle. But because I just gave myself the challenge, I just did it. There's also the self-discipline aspect of this challenge. The only way I was gonna get it done is if I was on top of it, and that meant writing every day. Even when I didn't want to, even when I was with other people or I had stuff I wanted to do, I always had to put this book before everything else I did. But don't feel bad for me. Like, I wasted my month writing this book, because I didn't. I was still able to hang out with friends and go on an amazing spring break trip, go to a frisbee tournament, see family. I was able to do everything else that I wanted to do. It just added another layer on top of it to really just cause me to manage my time more. I feel we often get so caught up in the lack of time in our life that we stop looking at the time that we do have. We have so many things that we want to do and things that we need to do, and it traps us in this mentality that there isn't enough time to do it at all. But really, we do. If we desire something, truly, wholeheartedly, we will find the time to do it. Stop waiting for that time to come, because you've only truly got this moment. If you're only waiting for one moment to come, it will. But then that moment's gone. And then what's left after that? Perhaps you'll find out that maybe you don't have enough time to do everything you want to right now. But you will. And you still have this moment. So do something with it.